Once upon a time, there was a pianist who played the most marvelous music and received the most enthusiastic applause. Once he was asked, "Will you play my favorite song? Here's the sheet music." Bedaffled, the pianist responded, "I'm afraid my sight reading is only so-so." And thus goes the story of too many pianists. As a part of the largest sight reading study in history, we are introducing boot camps, which is an immersion approach to practice sight reading. What's the point of a sight reading boot camp? This boot camp approach is designed to be used as a supplement to your lessons and sight reading practice. It was inspired by an immersion approach commonly used in learning a language. Learning a language through immersion is so successful, it made us wonder if learning music as a language can also be learned through immersion. Sometimes, however, adults don't handle immersion as well as children. Why is that? I like to think it is because adults have a different expectation than children do, which make it frustrating. Analyze this sentence. Tom cried because the ball hit him. Because adults understand every word, they're able to overanalyze the sentence. However, children do not have the same vocabulary, so they don't understand most of the words, and they hang on to the one word that is meaningful to them. The most interesting thing happens at the subconscious level through immersion. The subconscious mind takes the words that the child does not understand and files them away to be learned later. The same thing happens with music. The adult mind often wants to comprehend every little detail, and it overloads the conscious mind, making it very difficult and frustrating. If you could take all of that and make it simplified and just focus on one little thing, your reading would increase. And then at the subconscious level, you would allow all of the details to be filed away and come as needed. Let's go back to our story of the pianist who played well but did not sight read well, and compare them to the band players who don't have the same stigma of not being able to read well. So why is it that band players often read better than pianists? Well, there are lots of reasons. There's a lot of complexity in reading a grand staff. There are more combination of notes and positions on a keyboard with 88 keys. But the biggest reason is bands practice differently than pianists. In a band, you can't stop to ask your notes. The music just marches onward without you. And you learn this concept that playing on time is more important than playing the right note. We've taken the same concept, like a band, and put it into learning the piano through these boot camps. The music will march onward and not wait for you. And you learn that playing on time is more important than playing the right note. However, oftentimes people get frustrated. The reason why is because they want to get everything right before they move on to the next note, which is great when you're learning a piece, but not when you're learning to sight read. So if you could change your expectation, your frustration would go away and you would read much better. Let me share three tips with you to use while practicing your sight reading. Remember, relax and let your subconscious mind do its job. Tip number one, do not look at your fingers. Tip number two, prepare before you begin to play. Tip number three, look ahead. Let's look at the first tip. Not looking at your fingers. What happens so often is a pianist looks at the note, then looks at his fingers, looks to the next note, then looks at his fingers, then looks at the next note, then looks at his fingers, because he doesn't trust his fingers know where the notes are without looking. What happens is you lose valuable time trying to find your place. Great typists don't need to look at their fingers. Saxophone players don't need to look at their fingers. And great accompanists have learned they don't have to look at their fingers either. If you can learn how not to look at your fingers, your sight reading will improve immensely. Tip number two. You only have 30 seconds to look at a song. What do you look for? Remember, 30 seconds is not that much time, so use it wisely. The first thing I would say is look for repeated notes and repeated patterns. Next, notice the things that are relevant to you. Now, this will change as your understanding of music notation increases. And finally, try to get the tune in your head. Da 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 And then when you go back to play it, it is much easier. Tip number three. What happens too often is pianists read the notes they're playing and then they go to the next note. But by the time they go to the next note, it's too late. So they're always in a state of panic, not being able to read fast enough. What you want to do is back up. Look ahead as far as you can so that you're not in a state of panic and relaxed. It's better to miss some notes and look ahead than it is to play the notes and always be behind. I hope these tips have been useful to you while you practice your sight reading. Inside of Piano Marvel, we have 4 series of boot camps available to you. Choose the one you want, pick the level, and start your boot camp. Good luck. Remember, by May 31st, 2018, do as many boot camps as possible to enter into the iPad drawing.